Welcome to World Class Championship Wrestling, the Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars from the famed Cotton Bowl in the internationally famous State Fair of Texas. I'm Bill Mercer. Great to have you with us on this beautiful Texas evening. And we have a tremendous main event. The mixed tag team of Mike Von Erich and Stella French against Gina Hernandez and Erica Roberts. And that will be, of course, Andrea, the Lady Giant. We'll have all that and more for you on World Class Championship Wrestling. But first, we'll be back in just a moment.
This event, one fall, 30-minute time limit. This match features the captains for the World Six-Man Tag Team title, chosen by you, the fans, in the largest write-in campaign vote in the history of professional wrestling. First of all, on my left, from England, weighing 235 pounds, gentleman Chris Adams. He is assisted by his advisor, Gary Hart. And his challenger in front of me here in the yellow trunks from Denton County, weighing 240 pounds, Kevin Von Erich. The referee is David Manning.
Kevin Von Erich is seeking the American Heavyweight Championship. Chris Adams is looking for the World Heavyweight Championship. And Chris Adams wants to talk. You notice he got a
Kevin
lot of
Von Erich.
Negatives. Here's Chris.
Keep your kicking and your punching to yourself, because what I'm going to do is challenge you to a wrestling match, Von Erich, something that you're not very used to, and I'm going to embarrass you in front of your brothers, in front of your father, and in front of everybody here.
Well, Chris Adams hurling another challenge at Kevin Von Erich. And now Kevin wants the microphone. Well, Kevin does have a reply.
Adams, you want to humiliate me? You want a straight, clean wrestling match? Okay, man, you got it.
Well, we'll see which one follows through on this particular challenge. Gary Hart leaving the ring. Now, Fritz Von Erich has said that if Gary Hart interferes in any way, Fritz will be there like a postage stamp on an envelope all over. A little byplay there as David Manning introduces the wrestlers to each other. They well know each other. So Gary Hart must be careful, because somewhere in this giant Cotton Bowl, somewhere lurking, ready to spring out, is probably Fritz Von Erich. I have not seen him. I just know that he warned Gary Hart forcefully that if Gary interfered in any way, he was going to be there. Look at Fritz do his gymnastics. Well, Chris Adams didn't like that little light slap on the face. Chris. What is, see, he says now wants to keep it clean. Do they really, will they? Will they just do a straight wrestling match? It'll be very difficult after what has happened between them. This may be the first indication. Ah, they broke cleanly. Chris came off nicely. I wonder also if this might just be a ploy set up by Gary Hart to lure Kevin a bit into an area that he will be less cautious. And then all at once, Chris might explode on him. I don't know. I would hate to think Chris would be that way. Here's an arm-barred hammerlock. Chris Adams jousting with Kevin. And when you talk about the ability to maneuver in gymnastics and roll and leap and head about the ring, Kevin Von Erich is second to none. Kevin Von Erich, second to none. Kevin Von Erich, Chris Adams. This is about everybody's been waiting for since they parted company. Good hammerlock in by Adams. Rolling with Chris and staying with him. Rolling Kevin, Chris stayed with him. I remember when Chris Adams came to this part of the country from England, and he immediately became very close friends with the Von Erichs. At that hammerlock, Chris maintains it. Kevin tried to pick up some steam and come out of it. Chris rolls off. Kevin turned back inside. Nice move. Give 1 point to Kevin Von Erich. Chris a little upset. More with himself, I think, than with Kevin, because Kevin fooled him. Nice side mare move by Chris Adams. Stratford on Avon, England. The Bard lived there. Shakespeare. Chris Adams lives there. When he's there, of course, traveling about the world as he does the World Class Championship Wrestling, he's not in England very much. A super heavy, hard headlock put on Kevin Von Erich by Chris Adams. Gary Hart has not moved, but he has looked. Adam glanced around the arena. Nice leg takedown by Kevin Von Erich.
Come on.
There's another point for Chris. For Kevin on Chris. Barring those legs. Those legs. I've watched Gary Hart. Caught him out of the corner of my eye over there in the corner. And he looks around. Kind of furtively looks one way and then the other, as though he might be looking to see a large, strong adversary that he's known in the past, Fritz Von Erich. Right now, Kevin Von Erich in control of Chris Adams as that leg barred Chris makes it to the ropes, breaks, and Kevin breaks. No extraneous, no extracurricular activity. They have both played it fairly. And even though Chris is parted company with the Von Erichs, there's a British Union Jack flying in the hands of a young lady over. One young lady had "I love Chris Adams, I love Kevin Von Erich" on her shirt. Crowd looking back, and so is Gary as the fans are standing. Maybe they spotted Fritz Von Erich. Chris Adams moving in, fakes a toe hold, goes into the headlock and chin lock. Crowd standing up, looking back behind us. Everybody expects Fritz Von Erich to be here, to be around, and I'm sure he is. The Union Jack flies again over there as Chris Adams has Kevin Von Erich in that chin lock. Now Kevin breaks it. They were on the ropes. It may well be that Chris can maintain his normally gentleman attributes, even associated with Gino Hernandez and Jake the Snake Roberts and Gary Hart. I would find that very difficult to consider that he could do that for a long time, but nice move by Kevin. Up and a body slam by Kevin Von Erich. Couple of slaps, couple of slaps, couple of shots. Nice slap. Woohoo, get down, wound up. Little redness, little temper. Gary Hart making a signal as though to kind of cool it. Now Gary Hart putting his hand up and saying, cool it, there he is. Even in a regulated bout between two good friends, it would be difficult to maintain that quiet aplomb that professionals have to do when they're working under the rules. Chris coming in after that nice move against the quarter buckle. Chris Adams on Kevin Von Erich. Cotton, there's Gary Hart looking very carefully in. Not the hand across the face, but not in the eyes as Kevin Von Erich tries to use his great strength and agility to move out of this chin lock. Crowd into this one. Chris Adams and Kevin Von Erich working. A good, great crowd on hand in the Cotton Bowl. It holds 65,000 to 70,000. So. And here is a shoulder stand, but Chris Adams rolls out, and Gary Hart for the first time came out of his chair. And he looks around. And we see no Fritz Von Erich. Now they're all tangled up in that corner, and David Manning trying to untangle them. There's a couple of blows to the midsection. Those are legal. A clothesline. Chris Adams getting a little advantage now on Kevin Lunnery for that clothesliner. But Kevin driving his shoulder, coming off the blocks like a football lineman. Good move by Kevin. Chris Adams double kicked out of there. Kevin resting, getting a chance to recuperate. Gary Hart says, cool it again, using both hands to say, lay down easy. Don't get carried away. Control yourself. There he is. See that motion? Ah, yes, the famed Cotton Bowl. Speaking of people controlling themselves in great adversity. Oh, good wrist lock moving in. Adams on a twist. Kevin holds it on, got the arm, drags it, and maintains it. And speaking of men working under great adversity, one of the great quarterbacks of all time in the NFL, Don Meredith, played right here on this Cotton Bowl turf in those great formative years of the Dallas Cowboys. Kevin, and oh, Chris, with a hit on the break. Well, that's the first real impolite fraction of the rules that we've seen. Chris taking advantage of it. Kevin coming off, driving up is Chris Adams. A few of the fans for Chris as Chris jams in on Kevin, and maybe now it's open up. Nice side, high side mare move by Chris Adams, who now seems to think he's in control. A super kick, and Kevin Roderick is out on the floor. A super kick, and Kevin Roderick is out on the deck of the Cotton Bowl here at the State Fair of Texas. Fan over there with a sign, hand-painted sign. Chris is still number one. Kevin back in. Here comes Kevin. Nice move by Adams. Watch here. Whoa! Kevin almost in our lap as he flies over Chris Adams, who is running. Another. It's a flying drop kick, not a super kick. But Kevin stumbling out of the ring with a chance to rest. A chance to get a little bit. There's Kane. Adams flying out between the ropes on top of Kevin Von Erich. And Chris Adams back in. Chris demonstrating all sorts of maniacal moves here as he grabs Kevin and brings him back in. Coming up with a suplex, but Kevin turns it around. Now it's up and over. A shoulder stand. One, two, three, and Kevin Roderick beats Chris Adams. Kevin Von Erich defeats Chris Adams. Gary Hart is explaining it. Adams had his shoulder was off the mat. Well, Chris is a little upset, and you can certainly understand why he picked up the bell here. Kevin Von Erich, the winner, but Chris Adams feels he was robbed. I was looking for Gary Hart. He's right to my right here. And here's Kevin. I'll see if I can get him.
Hey, man. What are you acting that way for? That was a clean match, and I won it fair and square.
Gary Hart right down to my left.
Now, Chris, I'm going to make you a deal. I can't believe myself right now I'm making, but I'll tell you what. You fire Gary Hart. Get rid of him, and I'll try to bury the hatchet and forget it ever happened. Be water under the bridge.
Well, that's an interesting challenge. And Gary Hart is right here to my left.
Chris, here's a microphone. I'm leaving it up to you. Make your own decision.
And Chris is certainly thinking it over. Gary Hart up on the apron of the ring. And Kevin Von Erich hit from behind by Chris Adams. And having the chair in on Kevin Von Erich has gone absolutely crazy here, with Gary Hart now looking around, and he wants to get out of here. Kevin Von Erich smashed on the back of the head. Blood running down from the back of his head. He has been terribly hit from behind by Chris Adams. Gary Von Erich in the ring, David Manning in the ring. And Kevin lying on the mat here in front of us as Gary Hart seeks to escape. And escape is a true word because the fans are infuriated. And undoubtedly, Fritz Von Erich is somewhere about wishing to get Gary Hart's scalp.
Ted, give him a problem. Anybody, we're going to need an ambulance. Anybody, we're going to need an ambulance now.
I am sorry to say that from my point of view here, it would appear that Kevin Von Erich has received a very severe blow to the head. You see the fans, Gary Von Erich's around, some of the fans trying to get up to help, but David Manning is there. Kevin is conscious. His feet are moving. Listen, you can hear some of the discussion there. Kevin saying his feet and hands are burning. Now the Von Erich, bodyguards are here. The police are up here. And I think they have sent for an ambulance.
Hey, is that doctor in the dressing room coming? He said he's got no feeling, man. He said his hands, he can't do nothing.
And listen, David Manning, that there is no feeling in his hands. But undoubtedly, a concussion would cause that sort of reaction. So I don't want to bring you to a point of the worst that we could possibly think. At this moment, he is injured. I've called an ambulance. There is an ambulance on hand all the time, of course, for first aid and Cotton Bowl and other major stadia. And that's fortunate because right now, as Chris Adams came across the ring with that wooden chair, which is lying in the ring right there.
As the ambulance drives onto the floor of the Cotton Bowl near the State Fair of Texas, we'll take a break and return to this incident of Chris Adams and Kevin Von Erich on World Class Championship Wrestling. Paramedics have arrived, are now administering first aid to the stricken Kevin Von Erich, struck on the back of the head by Chris Adams in the match after Kevin had won it.
Kev, you need to try to stay still, man, okay? They're gonna take good care of you, just try to stay still.
Specially trained for this type of first aid.
Lonnie, they're gonna go to Baylor Hospital.
Preparing Kevin to take him to Baylor Hospital in Dallas. And of course his injuries will be diagnosed there. Huge crowd stunned by the severity of the attack of Chris Adams on Kevin Von Erich. Now Kevin Von Erich wheeled to the emergency ambulance, getting the best of first aid from these paramedics located at the State Fair of Texas. So here's the result of that dastardly behind-the-back attack of Chris Adams, a former friend of Kevin Von Erich, striking Kevin from behind with a wooden chair. And now the paramedics moving Kevin into the ambulance and onto the hospital, where his injuries will be diagnosed and he'll receive the aid that's necessary to put him back in shape to get back in that ring and wrestle some more. Stunned fans watching their hero from Denton County, Texas, Kevin Von Erich,
close the doors,
being taken to the hospital. Welcome back with more on World Class Championship Wrestling. Next week, the main event on World Class Championship Wrestling, a tremendous tag team event. Kerry and Mike Von Erich against Devastation Incorporated's Killer Khan and The Missing Link. Next week's great main event on World Class Championship Wrestling. And now, stay tuned for a tremendous bout featuring the man from St. Louis, Iceman King Parsons, and all the way from Atlanta, Georgia, Butch Reed, right here on World Class Championship Wrestling.
This event, one fall, 10-minute time limit. First of all, behind me, from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 260 pounds, Hacksaw Butch Reed. And his challenger from St. Louis, weighing 235 pounds, Iceman King Parsons. Your referee is Rocco Lubitsch.
Come on, ice cream boy. Come on, ice cream boy. I'm gonna whoop some ice cream out your drawers, boy. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna whoop all the ice cream out your drawers. You understand me?
Well, there's the threat laid out there by Hacksaw Butch Reed. And we'll see how well he pulls this off as he meets the tough young man from St. Louis, Iceman King Parsons. Away they go. Hacksaw just about works as his name implies. He'll hack and bash and try a little bit of everything and miss a few times. He's got an adversary and a flying drop kick by Iceman King Parsons. Moves right in on, and Hacksaw Butch Reed escapes to a sanctuary. And as the Hacksaw maneuvers outside the ring, reminds you that our main event is a great tag team, a mixed tag team, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French against Gino Hernandez and his lady bodyguard, Andrea the Lady Giant Nicola. Hacksaw missed again, but Iceman King Parsons has not missed a beat in this bout. He is moving to certainly the beat of the right drummer here against Hacksaw, who started out with a lot of mouth, now seems to be quieted a bit. Rocco Lubitsch, the referee. Oh, Iceman Butch Reed, maneuvering position here. Have not had a report from the hospital on the condition of Kevin Von Erich as yet. Kevin taken to the emergency ward of Baylor Hospital for examination following the attack by Chris Adams, hit him in the back of the head with a chair after Kevin had beaten Chris in the captain's match. We'll let you know as soon as we hear something. Boy, Iceman King Parsons is on target. He has given Butch Reed a what for in the early moments of this bout. The big man from Atlanta is groggy, staggering, and hanging on. Great crowd on hand for Wrestling Star Wars at the Cotton Bowl. Iceman hammering away, tattooing the Hacksaw Man. Well, it's been an Iceman show all the way. Hacksaw welcoming with a lot of threats, a lot of challenges, and all Iceman has done is accept all of them and return them in kind. Iceman King Parsons going for the victory right here, but not quite enough. Hacksaw trying to shake it off, but he's not having much success. Iceman keeps hammering home. Hacksaw has not done anything as yet. Oh, there he did it. at that knee up just in time and put Iceman on the mat. Now let's see if Hacksaw can follow through with something. Well, the crowd picks up the beat. So finally the tide turns for Hacksaw Butch Reed. Well, Hacksaw, with just a couple of shots, now comes back and gives a regain some confidence. And that'll slow down Iceman King Parsons. 5 minutes gone on this bout. Mr. Pulley just told us. Butch Reed trying to recover some of his lost ego in the early part of the bout. And there goes the Iceman with a sojourn on the floor. Hacksaw keeping Iceman off balance and outside the ring. We've just mentioned, of course, our main event is a mixed tag team. And coming up next week, a great tag team event. Kerry and Mike Von Erich against Killer Khan and the Missing Link. There are a couple of beauties from Devastation Incorporated. Michael Levy putting the count on Iceman Keen Parsons. Butch Reed welcomes him back. So this bout has gone one way or the other. All Iceman, now it's all Butch Reed. Certainly a man who is physically well built. This is Butch Reed, and Iceman catches him a little nonchalant. This might do it. If he can roll him up. Got him going and down and one. Oh, but a hammer on the head. Butch Reed's back in action. Well, Iceman Keith Parson looked like he had this one all sewed up. And right now, he is the one being sewn. Now, Butch Reed with a chance to win it, but Iceman fighting out of there. They get a double on the chin lock. Iceman and Butch Reed. Wrapped up in a tough battle on Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars at the eminently popular and successful State Fair of Texas. Internationally known for its magnificence. And a crowd trying to come up now to give Iceman a little bit of their support.
Shut up.
That's right here on the grounds of the internationally famous, one of the greatest, largest state fairs in all the world. And a Cotton Bowl that brings with history collegiate and professional sports. And Iceman's ringing a bell on Butch Reed right now. Whack. Oh, a good shot right through him. Iceman picking up the tempo. Look out. Butch Reed whacked back. Got him again. Body slam. This might do it. One, two, not enough. What a seesaw contest this has been. And a clothesline by the finish Hacksaw. Not quite, he's not hung out to dry yet. But there's the bell, and it's all over. And Iceman might have won it had he had just about 5 more seconds. But the bell ends this dramatic event of the Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars. Let's see if Iceman and Butch Reed got to get after a little bit more.
Bronco Lubitsch calls it a time limit draw.
But they're still going to have a few more shots. Butch Reed now decides that's enough. And he pulls out. So the Iceman is king of the hill. But this is a time limit draw. No winner. And we'll be back with the main event on World Class Championship Wrestling. It's the main event. Wrestling Star Wars at the Cotton Bowl in Dallas, Texas. And here's Stella Bay, Mike Von Erich, one half of this mixed tag team, Stella Bay French, the nemesis of Gino Hernandez, who is wrapping himself in all those championship belts. And his lady bodyguard, Nicola Roberts, better known as Andrea, the lady giant. And this should be a most interesting bout, as Ralph Pulley will.
This is a special challengers match, one fall, 45 minute time limit. First of all, over here on my right, the American heavyweight champion and the Texas heavyweight champion from Highland Park, Gino Hernandez. And his partner, Nicola Roberts, better known as Andrea, the Lady Giant. And their challengers, first of all, from Denton County, weighing 225 pounds, Mike Von Erich. And his partner, Stella Mae French. The referee is David Manning.
Well, Gino Hernandez covered up with the American and Texas heavyweight titles and the sixth man that Chris Adams, he and Jake the Snake Roberts took for the Von Erichs. This is an outdoor match and the fans are not talking about the natural sunshine. They're talking about the young lady known as Sunshine. Stella Bay's niece. And that's really kind of how Stella Bay got into all of this wrestling war, by coming to the aid and defense in the honor of Sunshine. But now here she is, matched up with Mike Von Erich against Gino Hernandez and Nicola Roberts. Oh, Nicola's gonna take off all the letters as Gino postulates about all the problems. Let's go, go. Now, David Manning explaining the rules and regulations as Nicola Roberts ready to go now with Gino Hernandez against Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French. And suddenly, lo and behold, here comes a helicopter into the Cotton Bowl, and the crowd sensing some excitement and some drama. And with our long lens camera, you can tell who that is right away. The exotic, the exciting, the girl with the face of a thousand expressions. There she is, she's back, Sunshine. Sunshine's back. Well, for a long time, Stella Mae French was searching for her. And now that Stella Mae has joined in the ranks of World Class Championship Wrestling, here is Sunshine back, and this should be a very dramatic, emotional experience, and it is. A great celebration. Even Mike Von Erich getting a kiss from Sunshine. She's back right at the appropriate time here for this match. And Sunshine, Stella Mae French, Gino Hernandez now talking about it as the bout is just about ready to go. and see what Sunshine's area of interest is going to be. Probably stay by the ring. This young lady with a great face. Emotionally, if you take a look at her, you know exactly what's going on inside her mind. You can just read that involvement. Stella Mayo started out against Nicola Roberts. And Stella May, the lady who handles those 18 wheelers, goes right to work on Nicola Roberts. No question about this one. She is a tough lady, and Gino Hernandez trying to save his lady as he leaps in and pulls her out of the ring. Well, that wasn't a very auspicious start for Andrea, the lady giant, with Stella Mae French just creamed her right in the ring. So Stella Mae right back. Nicola Roberts got to come back in. Let's see. Nope, it's got to be Gino. Gino Hernandez, formerly of Houston, now of Highland Park, a 24-carat suburb of Dallas. Mike Von Erich going against Gino Hernandez. Stella Mae and Sunshine reunited right here at the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. Good work by Mike Von Erich. Oh, the young Mike Von Erich, the youngest of the Von Erich clan, working on Gino Hernandez. Now Gino comes right back with the head scissors. Well, the word we've just been handed a note, there has been a diagnosis of Kevin Von Erich, a severe laceration in the back of the head. And it will require a number of stitches. First figure we heard somewhere around 10, 15, maybe a few more. That's a goodly number. And Kevin's also, let's see, a severe concussion. Those are certainly understandable, but not life-threatening as it first appeared when Chris Adams banged Kevin Von Erich on the back of the head with a wooden chair. Gino in trouble. But now right in the ring, Nicola, and here is Fu. A shot to Stella Mae French. A little taunting of Sunshine as those two ladies point the finger of despair at each other. Well, look at Nicola. She is going hard against Stella Mae French now. Stella Mae obviously in a great deal of pain. And Gino seems to be enjoying every second of it. Listen to the crowd. Well, Stella's having enough trouble just trying to gather breath right at the moment to get up and beat Nicola. And a choke. David Von Erich, or David Manning, rather. Now a Sunshine with a slap on Nicola Roberts. Sunshine working on a chair. Watch this. Wham on Nicola Roberts' head. And it looked like the rope caught some of that, absorbed some of the shock as Nicola went down. But there is Stella Mae putting the count on Nicola. I guess David Manning did not see Sunshine wrap the chair across Nicola Roberts' head, and Gino is furious. Sunshine comforting her aunt. Nicola trying to comfort her head, and Gino has nobody to comfort him. He is furious. He is out of his mind with anger and frustration. Sunshine belting Nicola Roberts on the head with a plastic chair. Fortunately for Nicola, the chair caught the rope and that absorbed some of the shock. Or we might have had to send for an ambulance for Nicola. Well, there's a happy threesome. Stella Mae French.
5 minutes and 19 seconds. Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French.
Yes, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French, the winners. The dramatic, emotional return of Sunshine to this event. And Sunshine has certainly participated rather dominantly in this match. And before we, before she leaves, let's see if we can't get her up here.
I love you, Dallas. Love you, Matt.
We'll try to grab her and bring her back just before she gets out of the area.
Don't be a lolly.
Again.
Back. Hey,
you got into the bout, didn't you?
Well, no. Y'all mess with my Aunt Stella.
Hey, it's good to see you again. We want to see more of you.
I don't know what my plans are, but I sure am glad to be back.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Sunshine. You made a nice entrance.
There she is, Sunshine. Her plans, well, as yet unknown. But I'm sure that if you ask Stella Mae French and Mike Von Erich, they'll say, let's keep that gal around for quite a while. Well, a tremendous event. The mixed tag team, the winners, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French. And we'll have more of World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars here on the State Fairgrounds, the State Fair of Texas. It has been extravagantly exciting. Well, we've had good news that Kevin Von Erich did not sustain any serious injuries. He had a few stitches in his head. He'll be okay. He'll be probably laid up a few days. Was exciting to see Sunshine come back. She made a wild and triumphant entry in a helicopter and certainly a wild and triumphant part in protecting her Aunt Stella Mae French. And for all and purposes, the six-man World Tag Team Championship did not come out well, but I think you know in your heart and mind from the last show that that was sort of robbed from the Von Erichs. Well, it has been a great and exciting moment in World Class Championship Wrestling. We hope you enjoyed it. That's it for World Class Championship Wrestling here at the famed Cotton Bowl on the equally famed State Fair of Texas grounds. I'm Bill Mercer. We'll see you next week. Be sure to join us on World Class Championship Wrestling.